I chose this place because people said there was nothing special here. For just this reason, I felt like I could find the truly Japanese scenery I love. The kindness of people living here is what I love about it the most. Everyone seems to have a brilliant gift for making others feel at ease. In autumn, the Japanese pampas grass comes alive in a blaze of glory. In winter, snow blankets the town. Burning of dried grass on the mountainside heralds the end of the long winter. On summer mornings, you awake with a song in your heart and seeing the dew trembling on the leaves. Another thing I love is the pure, delicious water. Surrounded by deep forests and mountains, with lovely clean rivers that irrigate its fields, it's a place where rice has been cultivated since ancient times. Harvest festivals are held there as they have been for centuries. The food is one more wonderful thing. No matter what fresh local produce you eat, it satisfies your body and soul. The other day I met an artisan who hand makes washi paper from bamboo. He too moved here from elsewhere, finding the perfect place to devote long years to a craft. The night sky on the Tonomine Highlands. Because it's so quiet, you can feel the sky above stretch out to infinity. Nothing special here. The only thing lacking is our ability to see, hear, and feel, which we have lost in the modern world. Kamikawa-cho is the place where you can rediscover it.